Google Cyberpunk 2077 and you'll find a series of dramas and scandals. We have hacking, crashes, glitches, and the rage of console peasants. And also there was the whole massive refunds thing lah, okay? Some would argue that it's more epic and popcorn worthy than the MCU, but still a better love story than Twilight. It is now March 2021, and out of the two major patches that we were promised, we've only received one, and the other one has been lost again in a sea of hacking. Being a member of the elite PC Master Race, we are probably the best bet at experiencing this game as the developers intended, which is why today, Mob House is going to present to you the ultimate, most comprehensive PC gaming guide to Cyberpunk 2077 in 2021. In case they decide to drop the price on this thing and you guys can finally afford it, I'm talking about you trolls that have been trolling about this game since launch, okay? Burn!
Yes?
Nobody is talking to you, Bernice!
Okay.
Wow, kids these days, they think everything is about them. Gamers have been waiting a long time for CD Projekt Red to release Cyberpunk 2077 since their last game, The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt, was considered to be a total GOAT, greatest of all time. You were the chosen one! You were supposed to bring balance to the Force, not leave it in darkness! And by darkness, I mean in the hands of Betty's dad and Ia. For legal reasons, we cannot say those names out properly. While the game ran relatively well on higher-end gaming PCs like this guy, lower-end setups suffered what looked like game-breaking glitches, which left it pretty much unrecognizable. If you want us to cover more about the whole Cyberpunk drama, leave a comment down below, but I think that it has been covered pretty adequately by everybody else by now. So, Cyberpunk 2077 in PC gaming. The first thing you need to determine is actually the resolution in which you're gonna game at, and that could be 1080p, 1440p, or 4K. While we're gonna go into the specifics of all these builds that we have painstakingly put together after a series of tests, we're gonna first give a shout out to our sponsors. Thanks for sending over all these parts for us to make this video possible. Before we get into the specifics of each of these builds, we're gonna share a little bit more about the peripherals that we used to game in Cyberpunk 2077, which are all from Logitech, which makes some of the best low latency wireless gaming peripherals, such as the Logitech G913 10 keyless mechanical keyboard, G903 wireless mouse, G733 wireless headset, and when we want to kick back and relax, we have the G560 speakers, which actually packs quite a bit of punch in the bass department that enhances your gaming experience. What's more, they all have RGB and can be synced together via the G-Hub application available on both Windows and Mac. Firstly, let's talk about the 1080p PC. For the CPU, we recommend that you go for the Ryzen 3 5300X because compared to previous generations, the new Ryzen 5000 series CPUs actually have better single-core performance that is vital for gaming. For the motherboard, we recommend that you go for a B550 motherboard because of PCIe 4.0 support as well as USB 3.2 Gen 2 for future-proofing. An RTX 3060 Ti is actually a sweet spot for this build because we found that it performed very close to the 3070, so you can feel free to save a few bucks and skip the RTX 3070. RAM speed and latency, as well as going above 16GB of DDR4 in a dual channel configuration, we found does impact 1080p gaming, but it does almost nothing for 1440p and 4K. So a sweet spot for a build like this would actually be 16GB of DDR4 in a dual channel configuration, rated at 3200MHz up to 4000MHz, and that is a good spot for price to performance ratio. To power this rig, we recommend that you go for at least 500 watts of 80 plus gold PSU. Of course, if you want to have a little bit more future-proofing, you can go up to 650 watts for this build and it won't be overkill. To flesh things out, feel free to go for a beefier air cooler or even a 120mm AIO cooler to keep your temps under control. A good companion for this rig would be a monitor with a 1080p IPS panel, 144Hz refresh rate, 1ms MPRT response time, like the BenQ Mobius EX2710. Because this game has very good HDR support, the HDR10 in this monitor will also come in handy. Also, the Brightness Intelligence Plus feature will help set the monitor brightness based on your ambient viewing environment, as well as your content, so you can game for hours with comfort. To top things off, the built-in travel speakers are pretty great in a clutch. Here are some benchmarks for this 1080p PC, firstly without ray tracing and DLSS, then with ray tracing on ultra and DLSS on quality. We're going to show you some tweaks that you can do to the settings later, but here are some numbers at stock. Numero dos, here is the 1440p setup. Firstly, for the CPU, we recommend that you go for the Ryzen 5 5600X and not the previous generation CPUs for reasons stated above. Also, for the motherboard, we recommend that you go for the B550 chipset, again for reasons stated just now. And since Cyberpunk 2077 is such a heavy game, we recommend that you skip the 3070 altogether and go for the RTX 3080 because it has 2GB more of VRAM and a faster memory clock and more memory bandwidth. For RAM, 16GB of DDR4 rated at 3200MHz up to 4000MHz in a dual channel configuration is a sweet spot here. To power this rig, you should go for at least 750 to 850 watts of 80 plus gold rated PSU, or you can go even higher if you want to upgrade your GPU in the future. Some PSUs actually come with a silent mode, so if you run your PC and it's using less power than a certain threshold, the fan would just shut off completely. So a higher capacity PSU would actually yield you a quieter PC in the long run. Feel free to upgrade to a 240mm AIO cooler to keep the temperatures in check and keep your CPU running chill. A good companion for this build would be a monitor with a 1440p IPS panel, 144Hz refresh rate, HDR support like the BenQ EX2780Q. Again, this also comes with BenQ's Brightness Intelligence Plus feature, as well as 2.1 channel travel speakers, which I think are some of the best sounding built-in speakers. Here are some benchmarks without ray tracing and DLSS, and then with ray tracing on ultra and DLSS on quality. Saving the best for last, we have this ultimate 4K Cyberpunk 2077 gaming PC with custom liquid cooling that you guys have been drooling over this whole time. Don't lie, I know. Cue the epic B-rolls. For the CPU, while you should be perfectly fine with a Ryzen 7 5800X, since there's no overkill in Mobhouseville, we went with the Ryzen 9 5950X, since we're also content creators. For the motherboard, we have the ASRock X570 Tai Chi Razor Edition. I prefer the X570 chipset over the B550 because it has more PCIe 4.0 lanes in case I want to run two 3090s in SLI in the future. Also, it supports up to two PCIe Gen 4 M.2 slots, and being a flagship motherboard, it also comes with the best VRMs, which should provide better overclocking headroom with my beast of a Ryzen 9 5950X. An RTX 3090 like this Zotac Gaming RTX 3090 Trinity with 24GB of GDDR6X is absolutely needed for 4K Cyberpunk 2077 gaming. In fact, at certain settings and in certain heavier scenes, it barely broke 60fps. However, the most recent update did improve things a little bit. For RAM, while 16GB would have been a sweet spot, we went for 32GB of Water RAM from Thermaltake, rated at 3200MHz, which we have overclocked to 4000MHz. To power this rig, we went for a Thermaltake Tough Power Grand RGB 1050W 80+ Platinum power supply, but you can go even higher if you want. If you are considering to run two RTX 3090s in SLI, then I would recommend you go for at least 1200W and above. To cool the entire system down, while a 360mm AIO cooler would have been enough, here at Mob House, there's no such thing as overkill. So we started with a 360mm radiator setup with 6 Thermaltake ring quad fans in a push-push configuration. I know, we've also tested it in a push-pull configuration and found literally no difference in the temps, so we decided to prioritize the RGBs here. For the reservoir, we have the Thermaltake DistroCase 350P with a giant distro plate behind the motherboard with a built-in D5 pump, as well as the new Pacific W7 Plus water block for the CPU. We then filled the loop with the Thermaltake P1000 pastel yellow liquid to complete our cyberpunk aesthetics. A good companion for this rig would have been a 4K 144Hz monitor, but they are pretty rare, especially with an IPS panel. We can't even touch 100fps with our 3090 in this game. So yeah. Instead, we have a monitor like this BenQ EW3280U with a 4K 10-bit IPS panel, 60Hz of refresh rate, and HDR support. And it's more than enough to give you an immersive gaming experience in Cyberpunk 2077. On top of that, the bigger 32-inch size, Brightness Intelligence Plus, as well as the amazing Travelo speakers, makes it a good fit for this beast of a build. Here are some benchmarks for this build, firstly without ray tracing and DLSS, and then with ray tracing on Ultra and DLSS on Quality. Now we're going to show you some settings that you should tweak to squeeze more FPS out of your PC. Here are the settings that we found during our benchmarks and tests that will impact your FPS the most. To be honest, with ray tracing on, graphics settings actually barely affected the FPS. Also, these are average FPS, which means that during some heavier scenes, you might see a dip of 5 to 10 frames, which is why we recommend the setups that we did before. With that said, here are some numbers with our tweaks. So, the patches have definitely fixed a lot of bugs and glitches, as well as given us some FPS improvements over the day one build. But we still think that there's a lot of work to be done before this game lives up to our expectations. For now, if you're one of those lucky gamers who has managed to score an RTX 3000 series GPU or the Radeon RX 6000 series GPUs, as well as the newer CPUs from both the blue and red team, then you should be able to enjoy this game in its current state. However, we would still love to see more content being added back into the game that we have seen as far as don't know how long ago, the E3 demo in 2018. Looking at CD Projekt Red's roadmap, we should be expecting some free DLCs to console us. Get it? Console us in the near future. So I'm looking forward to that. Once again, a huge shout out to all our sponsors because they are such lovely people that let us have free reign over the content, huh? If you thought this video is awesome, you know what to do. If you have any questions regarding all the parts that we recommend just now, or if you have any questions about parts that you would like to swap out, leave a comment down below, okay? And we'll try to answer to you guys. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the notification bell like your life depended on it, and follow us on Facebook and Instagram to see more shenanigans on the Mob House crew. And I will see you in the next one. Not the next two, next one. But you can go to the next two videos.